I learned, I traveled, I worked, I fought, and I conquered. This is the process of growth of my young guest of today. Hello and welcome to My Fair Lady. I am Geeta Modi, and this show brings to you young entrepreneurs, young women with startups from this amazing city, Surat. My guest today is really young. She finished schooling in the year 2014 and then went globetrotting to amass some more education. She has visited countries like Japan, Singapore, New York, and come back to her hometown to start with EduGoals, which is a firm which imparts education and knowledge to those who want to study in India and abroad. She was awarded the McKinsey's Next Generation Women Leaders Award in Singapore in 2020. So let's welcome this ball of energy, Prachi Jain. Welcome, Prachi. I'm so happy to have you here on the show.
Thank you, ma'am. My pleasure. Thank you for inviting me to this show.
My pleasure, my dear. And I want to, of course, know all about your journey because you're so young. I think you passed out of school just a few years back, half a decade back. And you're already on the roll. So just tell us everything. What happened after you left school and how you got here?
Right. So as you rightly said, I passed school in 2014. I did my schooling in Surat city. I studied in DPS till my 12th grade. And then post that, I embarked on a journey of international education. Mm. So after my 12th grade, I moved to Japan. So I was studying my undergrad degree in Japan. I had a great experience exploring exploring the matcha green tea and all the beautiful temples of Japan. So I was in a city called Nagoya. And then from there, I went on to do 1 year of my academic exchange at New York University. So New York City as a city was entire new experience
awesome
for me.
City, yes.
Yes, it had been my dream destination since the time I think I watched Friends, the TV show.
Of course.
So 1 year I was there studying, traveling a lot, working also. I worked as an undergrad research assistant with a professor. So New York City was like an eye-opening experience for me, and I realized that there is so much beyond me, my city and my country. The entire world is basically my platform.
Yes.
And after New York City, I moved to Singapore because I was working there for a few months. So 6 months I was working. I enjoyed that corporate life, dressing up, going to work, imbibing that work ethic that Singapore is known for, meeting new people, networking. And then because I fell in love with Singapore so much, I decided to do my master's education also in Singapore. So I did my master's in a very unique subject that is called technopreneurship and innovation.
Okay.
So they basically teach you how do you apply technology
into entrepreneurship.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Not managing technology, but more like how do you understand emerging technologies like AI, ML. These are the words we hear every now and then. But how do you use it in a modern day enterprise?
True.
So that was my education for 1 year. Just finished that during the lockdown, in fact, and then I moved back to India. After the lockdown got over in India and in Singapore, I flew back to my home city, Surat, and then launched my own venture, which is in the space of education and career guidance.
Right.
And this was a very personal space for me because I have had such an interesting journey of international education, India and then Japan and then USA and then Singapore. Okay. So I thought this is something that I can give back to my fellow mates or the younger mates who are aspiring to study abroad or aspiring to have a similar career trajectory that gives them a lot of enriching experiences. So that was my idea to start EduGoals, and now we are fully operational since the past six months, and I'm day in and day out interacting with young students, students in college, some people my age who aspire to do masters later, and of course parents also. So that gives me a great insight into the child psyche and what are they looking for in terms of their education and their personal development.
Great. Yes. Such an amazing journey. And you think after doing this whole thing and coming back to our city, our country, do you think that culture shock or rather the difference in culture and the difference in the psyche, thinking, the way the people look at education here, the way the people look at, you know, like you said, the world is your oyster, but a lot of people don't know so many things about education abroad. So was it difficult right from the beginning to educate the parents or the grandparents or the people around the
very students. Rightly pointed out. So just like when I went abroad, I didn't have that much of a culture shock. But after 6 years, when coming I came back, I got a reverse culture shock. Yeah. Because I had never been in India for more than 2 months. And now here I was coming back for good without a return ticket to fly back, setting up my business, sort of reorganizing and reestablishing my own network here. So yes, initially it was difficult to sort of educate and make the parents aware that why a career guidance is needed. Why do you need to look into the future and plan your child's future? Just like we take insurances and we do investments.
Of course. Yeah.
Education is the biggest investment one can do. Exactly.
Yes.
It's like one of the biggest gifts a parents give to our child, more so Indian parents, because Indian parents invest so heavily in their kids' education.
Right.
People abroad can't even think about it. They do their own jobs, they pay their own bills. But we are blessed and fortunate to have such parents. So
Very true.
Initially it was a roadblock, but through different outreach mechanisms, doing a lot of webinars, information sessions, I think from my company's perspective, I've sort of tried to bridge that and create that awareness in different communities in my own way that it is important to take charge of your child's future. It is important to think beyond what the school and the tuition classes are offering. You need to make sure your child is a well-rounded and a holistic individual. So doing that, it's in the process, hopefully can sort of overcome that and establish this for a fact that yes, it is important to have a very solid education and career roadmap for every individual, be it a child or even a young adult who wants to do something ahead.
So now with the new normal after COVID, you think people would think twice about sending their children abroad and stuff like that? Because a lot of things are available online and a lot of colleges are giving their education online.
Right.
So do you think this is going to be more difficult or it is going to be easier to get more people and you can get the online stuff for them?
Right. It's actually both ways. Mm. There is something called revenge buying that is happening in China. People are going all out and buying all the luxury goods there are. Because who knows, we may live tomorrow,
or not.
So similarly, there's one segment who's like, let me send my child to the best university that is.
Okay.
Be it Harvard, Cornell, given that the child gets admission. Because the more exposure he or she gets, the more enriched or a more holistic individual he or she will be. But then on the other hand, there are parents like, no, our kids are precious to us.
And we want them close to us.
Yes, we want them closer. So Surat is all right if they're living in Surat. If they're living in Mumbai, Mumbai might be all right. They don't want to think of sending them miles away to the west in a random city in the United States. So there are these two segments. But still, in general, people who are still who had aspired to study in a good university, they're still like on their plan. They are sticking to it because it's like a dream that they have nurtured for so many years.
So they could postpone it for some time, but they want to do
it. They don't completely do away with it. If they are aiming to study, say, economics in, say, University of Cambridge, they will work hard. They will make sure. I mean, COVID, no COVID, they will want to get an admission there. Now, it's unfortunate that you have to sit at home and take the classes and not be on the campus. But still, people who had that dream, they are still working towards.
So did some students go in this time after the pandemic also?
Yes,
after the things opened up a bit?
Absolutely. There's one student, he's like my cousin only because I've known him since a long time. He did go, he did get admission into University of Toronto in Canada. Unfortunately, he's still taking classes from his home, in his home city in India. But then as soon as the visa things gets cleared, he will fly. So even I am keen and I want these people to go there and get that kind of an experience along with the education. That environment is going to do a lot of good to them.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So in Surat, being a small town, small city, do you think the women's support, the ladies, the support which you get towards your career is a lot or the males think more about it, you know, rather than the female when you're talking to the parents and, you know, the mother is, no, this is what I want, or the father is, no, this, you know, how does it work here in a small town?
So I think traditionally it has been the males, even I have seen that. But fortunately, I have had a set of parents who have both always placed emphasis on education. They themselves are doctors, so they know what it means to sort of work hard for a long period of time, then set up something of their own, work hard towards it again. So especially my father, he has always encouraged me to go beyond my regular academics. Whatever I do in school and tuition was never enough for him. He always encouraged me that you must take part in this competition or this event or go for this international exchange. So for me, it has worked in a very good way that both of them were always on the same page when it came to my and my younger sister's education. And when we talk about the business community, yes, I think the women's support community is growing. It's still at its initial stages, but I just feel happy that it's there. We have inspiring people.
At least
like,
it's there.
Yes, I mean, we have inspiring people like you. You set a good, very good example for especially younger entrepreneurs like me who have just started, first time in business. So it's very motivational to see and set our aspirations that we would want to achieve something like
you. Yeah, because this is the future. And I think if that resource is not tapped fully, it is just going to go to waste.
Yes.
Okay, so when was that one phenomenal moment when you decided, no, this is what I'm going to do. This is it. And I can do it for all my life.
Right. I don't think there was one specific moment. So what happened during the past years was I was always the informal counselor come guide for a lot of my friends and my cousins that, oh, I want to go to the States. Which university would you recommend? Oh, is Singapore good or is Japan good or is States good or is Japan good? So I was always giving this gyan to them, you know, just as an elder sister or a friend or in whichever capacity. So I thought, any which way I'm doing it, why not make it my business? Because I am passionate about it. I really love interacting with people my age or younger people who are really keen to explore the world. And I thought if I can do it through the medium of education and guiding them for their career, I don't think there can be any better thing than that. So I think over the years, these moments, and of course my own personal journey that I have lived in three different countries, working there, studying there, just enjoying life there, I thought a lot of people there are like me who want to explore all of these things. So why not put them on a right path? So that's what I do through EduGoals, my company.
Yes. So where do you see your company? I mean, there are ways in which you can scale, and what is that level that it can go to?
Right. So right now we are doing outreach with a lot of schools within my city, beyond my city. Another aspect that I look forward to is digital first. So I don't want to be a company that's limited in this particular city of this particular country. Right. I want to have a very strong online presence so that no matter what, be it an Indian or a non-Indian, can sort of look up and be like, yes, these are the career guidance team that I want to talk to. So I want EduGoals to be that kind of a name. I don't want to be limited to like four walls of my office in my own city.
Yes.
I want to reach out to as many people nationally and of course as many people internationally also in the future. So having a very strong digital presence
would be
like
the next step.
Yes.
And you think because Surat is developing so fast and it's growing in such a big way.
Yes.
I think people digitally here also are getting into, people here are getting into these digital platforms for so many things.
Yes.
So I think that would be a better way to, you know, make them also understand these things when the parents also understand more about it. I think COVID did play a big role where people started getting more digital about everything.
Absolutely.
So that was one thing which changed, I think, in this city, which even I'm noticing to a great extent.
Yes.
Okay. Now that you are in this field and now that you are doing all these things, how do you plan your free time? What do you do in your free time?
So because new company, entrepreneurial mindset, I sort of am working all day and all night.
All the time.
But still, I feel that I'm really happy that my friends are also here.
Yeah.
They are also working from home. So we catch up every now and then. I watch a lot of movies and TV shows in my free time. Binge watching a lot of OTT shows these days.
I think that's become the new normal, in
fact,
for everybody to spend their time.
Exactly. I just pick up something and I make sure I complete it and only then leave that show. So that's another thing. And I'm cooking a lot these days. My sister is also home. So we plan a recipe together and we're like, today is Thai day. So we're going to make everything Thai. So we're going to bake one day. So I do all of these things and I always look forward to traveling. So if I'm not traveling, I'm always making plans for my next travel.
That I think I've seen it in a lot of ladies. I think I just recently had a friend who said my feet are just dying to get onto a flight.
Exactly.
So it was like every female I talked to, and I've not heard this much from males. So I don't know why, but I think
maybe it's this urge to constantly, you know, have newer experiences and opportunities. I'm just planning my national and international travels whenever they can happen. So I guess that is one bug that has bitten me. And apart from that, I'm active in a lot of different communities in Surat, be it related to business, be it related to encouraging women entrepreneurs, or in general, if there's a fun book club happening. I was associated with a quiz club in Surat. So all of these things just keep me on my toes, and I genuinely enjoy being a part
of it. And since now they are all online, you can find the time
easy.
To do a whole lot of things together.
I don't have to run from one place to another. So it sort of is easy for now to take part in these.
Great.
Yes.
It's a good journey, great journey in a good space and all. Now let's go to the next segment where we are going to do the sort of rapid fire, fast track sort of questions. So if you feel that you had to, there was a movie made on you and somebody had to play your role, who do you think would play it well?
Any actress from across the globe?
Which, yes, any actress across the globe.
I'm personally a big Priyanka Chopra fan, so I guess it would be like a dream, dream come true to have Priyanka Chopra play that role. Wow.
And with that, who is your biggest inspiration?
I think both my parents are my inspiration because I've looked at their lives, the different journey they've been individually and together.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Great. What would you... consider, you know, yourself, how do you describe in one word?
There was this quote that I found, sincere but not serious. So I like doing everything nicely, diligently, but never too seriously that I become too harsh on myself. So sincere but not serious.
Great.
Yeah.
Great attitude. And some book which is your favorite and which you think you can all the time keep reading it?
Again, I'll go back to my childhood, so it'll be Ruskin Bond's short stories and books. They are just phenomenal. They take me to the Himalayas and make me travel. So Ruskin Bond's short stories, basically.
Any travel which you want to do, which is on your bucket list, and that's the thing which you have to do before you leave this planet.
Absolutely. There's this one place, it's Bora Bora in the French Polynesia. That's like right on my mind. Always I'm on Pinterest figuring how is going to happen. So yeah, Bora Bora.
It's a dream destination.
Yes, 100%.
And the best place you visited till now?
New York City, Manhattan. I don't think there is any other place that has even a 0.25% of energy that city has. So, New York.
So true.
Yes.
Great. That was just the questions. Now you get to ask me one question and I give you Gita Gyan.
Yes, I have been waiting for this opportunity. So I have seen your YouTube channel. Of course, I've known you. I just feel that you're so dynamic.
Thank you.
My one question is, ma'am, what keeps you going? What is it that just keeps you motivated to try different things, be it, you know, the businesses you've done or you're doing, the YouTube channel that you've, you know, carved out, and anything else that you're doing right now? What is it, maybe one thing or multiple things that just...
It's multiple things.
Yeah.
I think I cannot do one thing at a time. Like, you know, I have to have my, fingers in 3-4 pies together. So I have to keep doing, even if I'm watching a TV, there is something else which I need to do. Or if I'm doing something else, then something else has to be at the side. So maybe I was like this from the beginning. But a lot of people ask me this question, what is it that keeps you going? And that is my one thing which I call is my FOMO, because I feel I'm going to be left out. I need to do everything before I to leave the planet.
Right.
So and everything is happening so quickly. When we were there, when we were young, your age, we didn't have so many opportunities you have. We didn't have so many avenues, especially the internet. I mean,
correct.
That is one thing which has just opened up the world for everyone. So I just feel that, you know, there is such a lot to explore, so much to do, and you have just so much time. So, you know, I want to just do it all, or at least as much as I can, so that, you know, I don't feel that I didn't even try. So that is one thing. And of course, some of the things like television, or what I'm doing, my acting and my YouTube and all those things, that was one wish when I was young, that I always wanted to act, and I wanted to get into the glamour world for some reason, not fully glamour world, but something out there, you know, and
to express
myself. And that I couldn't do when I was young. Life happened, there was a whole lot of other things, circumstances and all that. So I thought it's never too late, whatever the age, let me just get into it. Otherwise, yes. I'll never, you know, and I'll always keep thinking, oh, I never did this.
Right.
So might as well do it. So it was that.
Wonderful.
So I think it just, new things keep just coming and they just call me and I feel, okay, let me get it.
I think we need more women like you who are so dynamic and inspirational that they're just active and they set such great examples that being an entrepreneur, you can be a vlogger and a blogger
everything
too, right?
Yes,
so,
yes.
So wonderful.
Thank you. And I love to encourage, and especially my channel is all about encouraging women. It's a lifestyle channel where I want women to think that they can do it, even if they have houses, families, everything, they can balance, they can juggle.
Correct.
And I'm sure the support system at home now for everyone is there.
Improving.
People know and they want, you know, the ladies of the house to get out and, you know, do that. So I think it should help the channel. I've written a book on it, so that is also
great
there for people to see and understand.
Wonderful. I've seen a couple of your travel blogs. I guess just can't wait to get back to my phone and complete watching the rest of the
ones. We did that travel last year, and in fact I want to encourage people to do travel alone, especially women. You know, because they wait and wait and then maybe that doesn't happen. So and especially after 50.
Right.
What happens is, you know, sometimes you're stuck because you're alone and family doesn't want you to go, or maybe you have some
health
illness and health problems and all. So I want to promote travel alone for women.
Amazing. Amazing.
Yeah. So now we'll end this episode with your mantra of life.
Right. So there's one thing that in the recent times I've figured out that this could be my mantra, and for now this is
for
my mantra, is that I always want to be a student. I always want to have that curiousness, the inquisitiveness and all that hunger within me. So I never claim that I know a lot of things, or I don't want to reach that point where I can say that I know everything. Because I think there's so much more that every individual can learn, be or do. So that continuous growth is what I seek. And for that, my mantra is just be a lifelong learner and a student for as long as I can be.
Absolutely on the dot. I think that is also what I feel, you know. I never feel you know everything. You have to learn. I mean, today maybe I've learned a lot of things from you also. So everybody teaches you and goes. Absolutely amazing. I wish you all the very best in all what you take up in your future. Thank you so much
Thank
for spending
so much.
Time.
Thank you so much, ma'am. My pleasure.
So we met Prachi and you saw what a wonderful journey she's been on at such a young age. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Do put your comments, do subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you once again with another guest and another story. Till then, be fit, stay healthy, and remain awesome.